He took it down. You got to see this, man. You got to see this. Look at that. Did he want that? That's what happens when you're patient, right, Carl?
Color of money. In this case, it's the color of crappie. On this YouTube exclusive, we're going to talk about using different color crappie baits based on where you fish, water clarity, time of year, water temperatures. It all plays a part of the different colors available to crappie fishermen. Now, we all know that in crappie, there's a Christmas tree variety, every color under the rainbow, but which color is right? I'm going to break down some of the hottest colors that we use based on the time of year, the water clarity, temperature, etc. Just the different choices, so you can have tons of stuff in your boat, all kinds of colors tied on, but always certain colors seem to produce year after year after year, regardless of where you fish. So let me break down some of the hottest colors we use based on the different clarity of crystal clear water, murky water, and dirty water. What colors do we use that potentially you can use to catch more and bigger crappie? Here's some colors that I would pick fishing crystal clear water, whether I'm single poling under a float, dragging it, hopping it, skipping it, doesn't matter. Something with a little bit of chartreuse with clear, okay? I like that clear body bait fish. Another option would be like the blues, real light sky blue or robin egg blue with a bit of clear as well, okay, on the belly. Another option is like the light blues, little bit of flake in there, but nothing too obnoxious, okay? Just trying to keep it natural, because sometimes these crappie can be spooky, whether they're sitting on a nest, they're roaming around, or they're just sitting in deep weeds, okay? I'll use different bait colors, but I will rely on the natural tones quite a bit. And the salt and pepper ones really shine when those fish are a little spooky, okay? You know, heavy angling pressure and stuff. The smaller baits a lot of times can help you as well, but you know, clear, little bit of pepper in there. You've got some bigger bodied baits that have white with clear, a little bit of sparkle. And we all know it. One that we all use all the time, that one right there. It's almost got like a little bit of blue and red with clear, a little bit of white. It's a hot tone. Remember, this is about you being confident in the colors you pick. You know, that's why it's really important when you're fishing with buddies in the boat. And you fish in clear water situations, maybe tie on different baits and see the aggressiveness of the fish. Are they spooky? Are they aggressive? Like, what do they want? You know, but have variety. That's why you see us have a whole bunch of different rods in the boat, because whether it's clear water, murky, or dirty, sometimes those fish do the exact opposite that you think. So be prepared. These baits right here will shine when the natural tones can't get a bite. Crystal clear tap like water. I'll tie on the orange. I don't care what I'm using, man. A jerk bait, a little fin spin, bladed baits, vertical jigging. Something about orange with chartreuse provokes a strike. Sometimes that's just what you got to do. Just like smallmouth bass fishing, provoke a strike. Those fish have been seeing everything else from minnows to, you know, all different types of baits, tube jigs, you name it. You throw something that's totally different, like the orange chartreuse, you can provoke bites, and sometimes they can be bigger than average crappie. To help you catch fish, there's one right there. Big crappie? I think it is, dude. Oh, it is too. Look at this. Look at this. Oh boy. Oh yeah. Wow. Is this one gonna get invited to dinner? Let me think. Let me see. You wanna come to dinner? Hey? You wanna come to dinner too? All right. And look at that little hook. Look at that, where it is. Think he wants that magnet? Just pop it. Pop it. Wow, sharp, eh? That's what you gotta have. Right there. Yeah, he's an eater. Now, when you're faced with off-color water, okay, so you just can't see down 2-3 feet, let's say, okay? I call that off-color. Because when I can see my bait in 2-3 feet of water, it's pretty clear. You know this crap, you can see it. So here's some of the choices that I'll pick when the water's off color. It's not muddy, doesn't look like tap water, but this is the colors. Pink with chartreuse, white with chartreuse. The reds are really hot. Under a float, bouncing it through the weeds, bouncing off bottom, vertical jigging, or under a float, you can't beat it. And definitely the purples. Something about that purple with chartreuse. Crappie just love it. Different companies have different names for it. This one's called the therapist color. But that purple tone in off-color water is absolutely deadly. I'd say, look at that one. Oh yeah. That's what we're looking for right there, boys. Just finished saying, I've been catching up in that shallow stuff too. Look at that. Look where we took the therapist, dudes. Easy now. Look where that is right there. Is that a typical crappie gulf? You're joining your six buddies, buddy. Yeah, here are the fun colors. Dirty water sneaking up on those crappies, either spider rigging, single pole jigging, fishing deep water with the aid of electronics and stuff. Something about those bright, obnoxious colors just seem to get crappie to bite. I just love them. What will I use? Oranges with chartreuse. The greens, you can't beat it, man. Even in off-color water, something about that lime Kelly green with contrasting light green, it's killer in any size bait you use. Chartreuse, sparkle, you name it, man. You want to get the fish's attention. Bright chartreuse. We're talking bright, obnoxious. This is what you want. Neon colors to get their attention so they can see it. The easier crappie can see it, sometimes you get more bites. Again, what you use, it's totally up to you. This is just a reference of what we use and have different variety in our box, in our boat, tied on our poles, so we're ready. And last but not least, right there. See that one right there? I call that gold dust. But that's gold with contrasting chartreuse. In the water, you think, you know, murky water, they're not going to see it. Check out this video, what it looks like underwater. You still see it. And those crappie with those big eyes, you know they see it. Working it in a tree, in bushes, in weeds. Something about that little gold with clear, with chartreuse. It's gonna come up. He's gonna get mad at it. He's gonna get mad at it. I don't know how much. There he goes. Look how black he is. Look at how black he is. Let's go this way. Oh, little crappie. Look how black he was. You know where he was hiding, huh? He was hiding in the tree. He's going to come right towards you, fans. Whoa. Right towards you. Right towards you. When they get this dark, you know where they were hiding. Right in the thick of the tree. Again, we got some of those bigger ones. So regardless of what you use, think about the options that are out there. The bright, obnoxious oranges with chartreuse. The pinks with chartreuse. The clear blues, the natural tones. This is all about you having confidence. Find the baits that work for you. In crappie fishing, it's like any other kind of fishing. The baits you pick are the baits that give you confidence because you're gonna fish harder, you're gonna focus more. But this was a rundown on fishing clear water, stained water, and then murky water. Get out there, enjoy the crappie, because there's a color out there waiting for you to catch those big, beautiful slabs on your favorite lakes, rivers, and reservoirs. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us on all our pages dedicated to crappie in the links below in the description section of this video.